And here's the lad who's come from Liverpool with the laughs, Frankie Allen.
Frankie Allen, I was lucky enough to be the first comedian picked to appear on the very first episode, the first show of the first series of Bob Says Opportunity Knocks in 1987, and the opportunity to meet some fantastic acts that were working with me, Four Wheel Drive, the Gravy Brothers, also Kerry Wilson. Great night, and a fantastic night, 16 million people watched it, and it was a great platform for me to launch myself over the years into who I am today. Thanks to Bob Says Opportunity Knocks.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I make something perfectly clear about that title? Bob Says Opportunity Knocks. That's the title. Listen, I may say it, but you have the last word. Each week, you choose the champ. You name the number one. Picking that winner is as easy as picking up a phone. Here's how it works. I'm going to introduce you to half a dozen talented turns, fresh faces never before seen on network TV, each famished for favor, fame, and fortune. And we have searched for amateurs and aspirants all over Britain, people from every walk of life. You'll be amazed what we've discovered. We found a clown in County Down. We found a vent in Kent. A joker in Roker, a jester in Leicester, a freak in Leek, a balloon twister in Bicester, and a stripper who was very disappointing in the Bristol area. Tonight we'll give you six of the best, and at the end of the show we'll take a studio vote for a snap result. But it's your calls after the show's over that bring back a winner next week. Now, I'll tell you all about how to vote on the Bob Knox hotline after you've seen our Super 6. To keep it simple, each act has a number, and this is act number one. And the first knockings of opportunity sound for a quartet of smashing girls who only got together last November to form the singing group Four Wheel Drive. They met in the right place for big winners, Epsom, historic home of the Derby. Michelle Hooper is 19 from Tadworth. Aisha Alak is 18 from Ironbridge. Sonia Swaby is also 18 from Leicester, and Susie Cooper is only 17 from Sawbridgeworth. And here's where they study. The Lane Theatre Arts College. Let's join them inside. That's Michelle, 19. And Susie, 17. That's Aisha Alak. She gets that exotic name from her Moroccan dad.
And one, and two, and one, two, and push. Stretch and lift. Keep together, shell one, two, throw, up, throw.
And completing the group, Sonia, the 18-year-old. Time now for them to really start work. Yes, ready to start the real work of winning your votes. That's Aisha, Michelle, Sonia, and Susie. Opportunity knocks now for Four Wheel Drive.
Boring me to tears. After all these years, no sunshine, no moonlight, no stardust, no sign of romance. We don't stand a chance. I always dreamed I'd find the perfect lover, but he turned out to be like every other man I love.
and four-wheel drive. I'd like to know how they got into that gear. However, just as well my wife wasn't on the judging panel, or they'd never have passed the audition. She knows nothing about pop music anyway, my wife. When people talk about Michael Jackson's latest waxing, she thinks he's having his legs done again. But hark, I hear the knocking of opportunity. It's the big chance now for act number two. And let's show a little mercy for the loneliness of a long-distance comic. For here in the city of bitter bankruptcy and lacerating laughter, we found Frankie Allen hotly pursuing his ambition. Born and bred in Liverpool, this restless bachelor seems to have been in a hurry all of his 32 years, moving on from being the class clown at school to jobs where he was bored in a bank, careless as a clerk, dreamy at a desk, and finally set free by a building firm who just didn't need a trainee surveyor more interested in humor than houses. What makes Frankie run? He's chasing a dream, just like Paul McCartney and George Harrison, who studied at this very same institute and nursed the same fancy for fame. Frankie has a Merseysider's native wit, the kind that instantly gave that proud cathedral of theirs the name of Paddy's Wigwam. But don't worry about Frankie running out of puff. He's just keeping fit to pass the winning post by winning your votes tonight. And here's the lad who's come from Liverpool with the laughs, Frankie Allen.
Good evening. Fella just come up to me in a bar before. He said, hey, Frankie, you're a Scouse, aren't you? I said, yeah. He said, what you call a Scouser with a shirt and tie on? I said, I don't know. He said, the accused. He said, what you call a Scouser in a four-bedroomed house? I said, I don't know. He said, a burglar. He said, what you call a Scouser at university? I said, what? He said, a caretaker. Good to get out and have a laugh, though, isn't it, eh, wherever you're from? I was watching the other fella the other night, Lou Ferringo, remember him, the Incredible Hulk? Imagine having a bevy with the Incredible Hulk and you knocked his pint over. You'd say, all right, Lou, keep your shirt on. Have you seen him when he gets angry? He expands to 9 times his normal size. And his pants stay on. No wonder his face goes green. His pants burst 1 week, he had to shut the show down. Running down the street 75 miles an hour, bare naked. Some old woman saw him and screamed. She got knocked over on the road. Just goes to show you, done it? It's not always safe to cross the road when the green man's flashing. Before I came to London, I thought every publican had glass in his ear. I was in this Chinese restaurant in Liverpool last week. It was that rough, even the chicken legs were broke. This Chinese fella walked past our table 8 times. I said, hey, you. He said, how you know my name? I said, hey, mate, you do takeaways. He said, yes, fuck, I'm sick leave too. I took this girl out, this big fat beard, took her out on a date, you know. She was dead fat. She was dead eager-like. She turned up in a wedding dress. Terrible ugly, though. You should have seen the state of her. She had a face a hyena wouldn't laugh at. When she was a kid, her mum had to feed her with a catapult. You had to put shutters on the pram. She opened the fridge and the fish fingers went for her throat. When she was a kid, her dad had a tie of pork chop around the neck so the dog would play with her. When she sucks a lemon, the lemon pulls her face. Put the lipstick on it, backs into the tube. I felt sorry for her, so I took her to Blackpool. The fella gave her the money back on the ghost train. I took her to see Frankenstein. We were waiting in the queue outside, and Frankenstein ran out of pictures to have a look at her. It's funny how I met her, though, in Liverpool, walking down the street. Walking past a block of flats, and I saw something falling through the air. I thought, what's the score here? And I caught it, it was a glass eye. Thought, aye, aye. So there's this old woman standing at the bus stop. She's your ace, son. That belongs to that girl in the top flat. 22 stories. I said, I'll take you up to her, I'll be able to cop for her. So we got in the lift, right to the top, rang the bell. This girl answered the door like that. I said, hey, love, I'm not being funny. Is this your eye? She said, yeah, it fell out before I was cleaning the window frame. She said, come in and have a drink with me. I said, all right, so I came in. She said, I've got a bottle of wine here. I said, all right, open it. So she opened the wine, give me a bit, I'm drinking it like that. Put her arm around me. Started nibbling my ear. I said, this is all right. So I started going like that. She went like that, she pushed me away. She said, get off. I said, what's wrong, love? She said, don't get the wrong impression. I said, what do you mean? She said, I don't do this with every fella that catches me eye.
That's good. What a pleasure. Fast, assured delivery. He'd never make a postman. Frankie Allen. If you're making a note of the names at home, just put his initials F.A., which is one reason he hates being called sweet. And he was Act Two. Now, our policy on this series for newcomers is opportunity knocks, not critical knocks. Because I remember all too well when I started in show business, I did so many auditions, I thought my name was Next. So, if you'll please keep up this warm, receptive atmosphere, I'm sure we'll get the very best from our third seeker after stardom. Here's Act Number Three. Is this a ride to fame on a horse-drawn brewer's dray for a Barbados beauty named Zeitia Massiah? It's been quite a trip, leaving the West Indies when she was 5 to join her dad in Britain, singing in school concerts and graduating at age 11 to solos in church. Zeitia left school at 15 to become, guess what? No, she doesn't sing the beer commercials or even serenade the salesman. She's the office temp. Well, at the end of a hard day's songless slog at the typewriter, at least there's some lubrication for her neglected tonsils. A temp's tipple. As Zeitia pauses to consider, what if instead of a temporary tap, opportunity knocked? Is Zeitia ready for champagne? Only you can tell us that. Is it champagne or shandy? Opportunity knocks for Zeitia Massiah.
You ask me if I love you, and I choke on my reply. Rather hurt you honestly than mislead you with a lie. Who am I to judge you in what you say or do? I'm only just beginning to see the real.
Subside. Anytime.
know how hard you've tried. I've watched while love commands you, and I've watched love pass you by. At times I think we're drifters, still searching for a friend, a brother or a sister, but then the passion for
Zeitia Massiah, act number 3 on your list. What a talent. If there's one thing I've learned as we've travelled around the past 4 months, whatever we're short of in Britain, oil, money, jobs, people who do a good impression of Roy Hattersley, people who have a good impression of Roy Hattersley, we are not short of talent. We've spent 30 weeks touring the country, 26 looking for talent, 4 looking for the producer. We found him in hospital recovering from self-inflicted love bites. Oh, you know him. And I must say, the BBC didn't exactly book us into the best hotels. That one in Carlisle, please, they had towels stolen from other hotels. I've slept in a room with cockroaches before, but it's the first time I've had one climb into bed and throw one leg over me. It was murder, folks. We came down to find the chef had laid on an English breakfast. You could tell he had egg yolk all down his back. All right. It wasn't a 5-star operation, but we are a 6-star operation. And I've just been given the signal to present our 4th star. Here is act number 4.
Yes, you say 7 to 10 days delivery. Yes, that's right. Should be with you next Wednesday. Okay, thanks. Bye.
Kerry Wilson from Stoke-on-Trent, a telephone sales clerk and typist in the family firm. Maybe it's all the millions of mirrors Kerry has to sell that inspired her urge to reflect the images of the famous. Kerry's always loved to entertain by acting like a human looking glass and mimicking her family and friends. But she never thought of having a go at reproducing the stars until last year when she was 17. Already, she can display an impressive stock of celebrity simulations in her own personal hall of mirrors. But who's this reflected in Kerry's mirror? Could it be some phantom from an opera? Opportunity knocks now for Kerry Wilson.
Surprise, surprise! It's celery! Thanks ever so, Chooks. And we've got a lot of surprises for you tonight. Here's another one. Miss Joan Rivers. Oh! Oh, please. Oh, please, can we talk? Oh! Oh, life in general's been getting me down. It's the only thing that does lately. Spit on marriage. Ah! Ah! Heck! Hi. Who went? Today. Noose. I'll never be a yellow coat. Listen, do you know something? I only got on this show, you know, because I do impressions. Yes, I do. I do a lovely one of him out of Rising Damp. You know the one I mean. He goes like this. He goes, my goodness, Jones. Oh, Mr. Rigsby. Oh, Mr. Rigsby, everybody always seems to do you, Mr. Rigsby. But nobody ever seems to want to do me.
Well, I'm free. Well, I'm not free, but I'm very reasonable. What do you say, Mrs. Slocum?
Do. Do you mind? You're upsetting my pussy. Boo.
Well, for a change of mood now, I'm going to sing a song. It's a very moving, touching, heart-rending number that Catherine Hepburn sang to her husband, Norm, in On Golden Pond. Thank you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, you old poop.
Oh, I say. Oh, hello there, Lou. Oh, Lou, you're going to help me, Lou.
Will you want your wood bag and jump the weed?
Oh, Lou, you're going to help me, see? I mean, oh, I can't sleep at night. I've been to see Dr. Legg. I mean, what with my neck coming back and Mary upstairs? Oh, and all these attackings going on, it's knocked the stuffing right out of me, Lou. Well, I can't sleep. It's since I got done for shoplifting.
Well, here's your bandage, that dead dot. A weed. Those shops are bloody heavy.
Oh, I say, I should have known you wouldn't understand. Oh, look, here comes Pauline. Hello, Pauline, love.
Oh. Oh. Mum, Dot. Oh. I just got back from that laundrette and I've just seen Arthur. Oh, still no change. I said, Arthur, love, I'd better be going. Is that clock right? He said, don't be bloody stupid, Pauline. It wouldn't be in here if it was right. Oh, Michelle, love, shut that baby up.
Look. All right, Mum, I can look after Vicky myself, all right?
Yeah, I can help you look after Vicky as well, I shall, yeah. Look, here comes Ethel.
Oh, dear me. Oh, look, there's my friend Angie. Oh, Angie, you've got to help me.
Hello, darling. Cool blimey, Ethel. What can I do for you, eh, babes?
Oh, dear me, Angie, see, I've got this terrible problem. Oh, well, actually, it's not me, it's my little Willy. Oh.
Cool blimey, Ethel. It's your little Willy, eh, darling? What seems to be the matter with him, eh?
Oh, dear me, you see, he's only got one eye.
He's only got one eye, eh, babes? Here, Ethel, darling, let's have a look at him. Here, Ethel, you've been holding him upside down, darling.
Kerry Wilson from Stoke-on-Trent. She's only 18 years of age. Gosh. That's the same age I was when I made my very first radio broadcast. And it's funny, I can actually still remember the exact words that I said. Yes, Mr. Marconi, you're coming through loud and clear. Gosh, isn't it funny how these memories stay with you? It took me a long time to get started in show business, mind. For 10 years, I thought a star on a dressing room door was some sort of Jewish toilet. But I was always stage struck. You know, I must admit, like so many of the artists you're going to see on Bob Says Opportunity Knocks, I would do anything to appear in public. I can remember standing in front of an audience wearing a sailor suit and singing on the good ship Lollipop. And this was last Thursday. Why am I standing here talking about the past when it's the future that counts? And I'm sure there is a great future ahead for our next act, Act Number 5. And a waiter in the wings. Waiting at tables in his parents' Greek restaurant in Great Yarmouth is Kyriacos Kikis. Kerry for short.
Good afternoon.
Hey, we'll just there, please, just for a minute.
Born in Norfolk, Kerry was only 4 years old at play school when he first tinkled at the piano. Well, now he serves moussakas instead of mazurkas and prepares to sit his O-levels at Great Yarmouth College. But his mind's not really on lunch or lessons. Kyriacos is happiest at the keyboard. Largely self-taught, he's longing to let these diners sort themselves out, smash the plates, and go home.
Sorry, madam.
Kyriacos will give his life to the piano and the public, but meanwhile he waits. Waits for the sorting out of the shish kebab, the placing of the pitta, and the knocking of opportunity for a young man who longs to quit serving up the classic dishes and start dishing up the classics. No need to beware Greeks bearing musical gifts. Opportunity knocks for 18-year-old Kyriacos Kikis. Kyriacos Kikis, a polished piano performance, because the trouble, I think, with most children in this country is they start to play the piano, they never get further than chopsticks. Chinese children, of course, play knives and forks. Sounds very similar. I've been amazed at the range and scope of amateur performers who've auditioned for this series. Only last Tuesday, the Chancellor of the Exchequer gave us a speech from Hamlet. 2p or not 2p. Well, it's budget week. I had to get one in. I see unleaded fuel is going to be cheaper. Did you see that? I have always used it, and people are impressed that I do. I think wherever I go, I hear the girls whisper, "There's Bob Monkhouse. He's got no lead in his petrol." I love to follow the news items. Did you see that photograph of wee David Steele collapsing over the curvaceous Clio? Talk about scotch on the rockus. But then David's been a little giddy since the Alliance wins at Greenwich and Truro. He said, "We are the third party." I thought, blimey, the other two must be fire and theft. Well, I'm glad you like to laugh, because that's just what you can do some more of. After you've met, act number six.
Yeah, those two fingers, right?
The Gravy Brothers, hoping to strike it lucky on our show tonight, are in reality Andrew Bolton, obviously a teacher from that instruction he's giving, and Ian English, who's not so obviously a quantity surveyor. They're an unusual act. Give you an idea of how unusual they are, they think they're playing tennis. Andrew teaches drama at a local county secondary school, so he's used to appearing in front of an audience. Although Ian maintains he works to an audience as well, those strange crowds which materialize from nowhere whenever men start working on the roads. While Ian goes in search of his bowling ball, let me tell you how, over the last 2 years, they've polished their act through local folk clubs and taken the name Gravy Brothers to put a bit of beef into it. And they're hoping tonight will be their lucky break. Without giving anything away, I think I can promise you their approach to comedy is as original as their approach to 10-pin bowling. But it's all calculated. They may have lost their bowling ball, but they have not lost their marbles. Oh, no, the Gravy Brothers are off the beaten track, all right, but they could be on the road to stardom. With a totally original way, unaccompanied, a cappella, opportunity knocks for the Gravy Brothers.
Hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more.
What you say?
I said,
hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more. Oh, woman, don't you treat me so mean. You're the meanest old woman that I've ever seen. I guess if you say so, I'll have to pack my things and go. That's right, hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more. Jump on the bus, Gus. Boom,
jump off the keelie,
boom, boom. Let yourself go, Joe. Boom,
cut yourself loose,
boom, boom. There are 50 ways to leave your lover.
Hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack. Don't come back no more.
Oh, baby, oh, baby, don't you treat me this way, because I'll be back on my feet someday.
I hear what you say, but it's understood. You ain't got no money, you ain't no good.
Let the children say, hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more. Jump out of bed, Fred.
Boom. Give us the spiel, Neil. Boom.
Turn on the gas, Sid.
Boom. Get on your bike, Norman.
Boom. There are four more ways to leave your lover,
lover.
Don't you come back, don't you come back, don't you come back, yeah. Do-a-ba-do-ba, don't you come back, don't you come back, don't you come back, Jack. Do-a-ba-do-ba, don't you come back, don't you come back, don't you come back, Jack. Do-a-ba-do-ba, don't you come back, don't you come back, don't you come back, Jack. Hit the road, Jack. And don't you come back. No more. Oh, yeah.
That's original if you like. The Gravy Brothers. The Gravy Brothers. Don't be misled by their antics. Those lads have got an IQ of 150. Between them. In a moment, I'll remind you of the acts that you've seen, and we'll take a studio vote for a snap result, shown on this massive scoreboard. But it is your calls at home that count. You are the star makers. Each act has a phone number listed from 1 to 6 on today's page of the Radio Times. And once you've decided, with your family, perhaps, on who deserves your vote, you dial the number of your choice. Your vote clicks on our computer, and the whole thing costs you the same no matter where you're calling from, I ask you. Where else can you click with a real winner for 5p these days? The Bob Knox hotline opens up in about 7 or 8 minutes at 8:35, and it stays open until midnight. And then you phone in your vote for the top act, you'll hear my recorded acknowledgement, and you hang up. Because, star maker, you've scored a point for your favorite term. We've got over 500 lines open, but if the number you want is engaged, please be patient with us, because it only means that a lot of other viewers share your opinion. Are you ready for a memory jog? Okay, here's where our six hopefuls return, and the studio audience gives each the applause they feel is deserved. That applause will be digitally analyzed, separated, laundered, equalized, squelched, and turned into star value. So here we go, first of all, with another burst of the engine from four-wheel drive. Blind 70 for four-wheel drive appears on our giant scoreboard. 70 from our studio audience for Sonia and Susie and Michelle and Aisha. Very nice first score. Very well done for the girls. Down there in Epsom, they'll be cheering. Now let's take a reminder of that funny fella who came from Liverpool to perform like this, Frankie Allen.
I said to the Chinese fella, I said, there a minute, mate. He said, what do you want? Why, what? I said, there's Jews all over the world. He said, but do you ever get any Chinese Jews? He said, wait a minute, go find out. And he walked away. 5 minutes later, he came back. He said, Sally Flanky, no Chinese Jews. Only orange Jews, lemon Jews, black Jews. Hey,
well done, our Frankie. Frankie Allen from Liverpool scoring a superb 84 on the scoreboard. Oh, that's terrific. A next trainee surveyor, and he comes down to London a little bit worried about how you're going to like his Liverpool accent, and he's scored 84. Very thrilled for Frankie Allen. Now, let us remind you of act number 3, a lovely Barbados lady who sang superbly. Her name, Zeitia Massiah.
Thank you.
well done, Zeitia. Despite my pronouncing your name wrong for a moment, you got 86. Isn't that great? Will you look at that 86 up there? 70, 84, 86, rising approval from our studio audience. Remember, it's your votes that you phone in after the show's off the air tonight that really will decide the winner. But we're getting a snap vote from our audience tonight, and that's telling us a lot about what they think and how the impact of our various performers was effective in this studio. Studio 8 at Television Center, where Kerry Wilson made her bow. 18-year-old impressionist, let's remind you of Kerry Wilson.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Mavis, love, give over with it. Do you know, I told Elf the other day, I said, Elf, if Gail had wanted to know whose baby it was all those months ago, she should have gone and had one of those scans. If the baby had got a normal size brain, it was Ian's. If it had one the size of a pea, it was Brian's. What do you say, Mavis? Well, I don't really know. You see, I've just had to slap Derek's face four times. What do you mean, Mavis? Do you mean he tried it on? No. I thought he was dead.
Kerry, did you see what she's somewhere watching and doing this? Kerry Wilson just saw herself get an 86 on the scoreboard. How terrific. She's level pegging with Zeitia Massiah. Oh, what a thrill. She'll be on the phone in a minute to stoke on Trent saying, hey, guess, because what I've got. Very thrilled. I'm sure she will be. Now, a young man, also 18 years of age, came down from Great Yarmouth, a young man from a Greek family who catered to Norfolk folk for a long time and played most impressively. Here's a reminder of what Kyriacos Kikis gave us. Handsome young man of 18 won a few hearts here because there's some lovely girls in the studio audience and they went, to for Kyriacos, and he has a very, very handsome score of 77 to match his good looks. Now, as you can see right now in the lead, neck and neck, Zeitia Massiah and Kerry Wilson. Can the Gravy Brothers top those scores of 86? Let's remind you just which road the Gravy Brothers hit.
Hit the road, Jack. And don't you come back no
with 74. Hey, with our very first edition of Bob Says Opportunity Knocks, we have a dead heat. We're only supposed to bring back one act. Thank heavens it isn't my decision. After all, we're still waiting for your decision. That's the studio audience vote, and it doesn't actually affect events here in the studio. No, I was just kidding you. The Bob Knox computer is waiting for your decision. It's waiting, and so are we.
impatient to know which talent you're going to tip for the top. You from now until midnight to reach for the phone and reach for a star. It's your decision. You're the star makers. Next week, the winner you choose will return to join five more eager newcomers. So, until next Saturday evening, Bob says, if opportunity comes your way, don't knock it. Good night.